topic is on sustainable strategies for water resources development using rainwater. I extend a warm welcome to you, sir. Now I request you to take over the session.
How are you? Can you hear me? So, how many of you are engineering students in civil engineering? Yeah. How about the others? The electronic, electrical engineering. Any MTech and master students? So, anyway, now, electrical kata bata, what? Electrical.
Last 100 years. Okay, before saying 1,000 years it is not changed. But 100 rainfall has not changed. 4000 billion kilometer. What is that? 4000 billion meter cube of water. Billion is 10 to the power of 9 meter cube of water. This is not changed. How much of that water you are utilizing is the question. That means totally including what goes into the ground and what is stored in large dams and carries,
ಮಾನ್ಸೂನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ತಿಂಗಳು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ವಾಟರ್
ನೀನು ಹಂಗೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಕುಡಿಬೋದು. ಅದನ್ನು ಸಮುದ್ರ ಸೇರಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಆರ್ಒ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಇದೆ, 10 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತವ ಇದ್ರೆ ಇಸ್ರೇಲ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಇಸ್ರೇಲ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಚಿಂತ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಸಿಟ್ ಅವರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೊಲಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ಅನಿಸಿಕೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ವಾಟರ್ನ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ, ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಒಂದು ನಮ್ಮ ಮದರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ 30-35% ರಿವರ್ ಕೋರ್ಸಲ್ಲೇ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಸರ್, 30-35% ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಲೂಸ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ 35% ಪೊರಾಸಿಟಿ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ 25% ವಾಪಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ವಾಟರ್? ನೋ, ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಬೈ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ, ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಬಾಂಗ್ಲಾದೇಶ್, ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಮಲೇಷ್ಯಾ, ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಇಂಡೋನೇಷ್ಯಾ, ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಥೈಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ತೈವಾನ್, ಆಸ್ಟ್ರೇಲಿಯಾ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕನ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್. ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ವಿತ್ ಪ್ರೈಡ್, ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 3 ವಾಟರ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸಸ್, ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋ ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ IAHS, and one more international water resource association. All the past presidents, please remember, hear this clearly, are vice president of my society. I will leave one or two newsletters here with you. We are meeting in Australia. So this is a concept wrongly spread by many people. So we are, everybody is coming back with us. Utilizing flood water is the way for the future generation. That means, I am not even talking about you, sir. Your grandchildren will only drink water from coastal reservoirs. There is no other reservoirs. Because, one more thing I want to tell you. All the dams were built in 1970, 80, 90. Correct? How many years now? 70s and 23, 30 plus 70 years. 40 years. Dam would be the life of the sir. Now, 100 years ago, 110 years ago, you go and check up every time and do exercise. And one time your body, that means rehabilitate yourself every year, every day. Then you can live for 100 years. But beyond that you cannot live. So imagine America is demolishing 800 large dams. Are they going to construct those dams at the same location? No. Nobody will allow them. That means those dams are gone. So where are you going to construct and store water? No more in large dams. So you need to think about something. That is small way, small and beautiful, what our ancestors followed. I will show you that also. That means there is a balance we need to have, but our requirements and demands are large from industry and agriculture. For them we need to find place to store water. For drinking and domestic, our rainwater harvesting definitely we have. So let me give you that. So this is the data. You see, 1901 to 2013, 113 years of data. Can I show you one thing? This is 1000 millimeter. So you please look at this line. 1 year, 2 years, given that every year we have received average rainfall 1000 millimeter in India. 1000 millimeter is a very large amount of rainfall, sir. And your place is blessed with 4000 millimeter rainfall. This Bangalore and the coastal areas, 4000, Kerala, 4000, 5000 sometimes. So, average annual rainfall in India is 1176 mm, looking at 113 years of Central Water Commission data. This data is very, very accurate. Believe me, why? Because we have fantastic network of rain gauges in the country. By IMD, maintains every district and quarterly row, and see fantastic rain gauges are there. It goes automatically to IMD. IMD collects all the data, puts you online. So the deep dive, this data need not be questioned. Water storage is very essential. For what? For irrigation, drinking water supply, and hydropower. We have done time and time again. To provide a buffer for flood management, also people have storing water. Again, flood to control, now dams control. Annual water storage available per capita in India is 225 cubic meters per capita annually. This is a very small number for our population. Chinese have done much better, sir. Chinese have done 1200 meter cube per capita. We have 125 equivalent to Ethiopia. Can you imagine? We talk about the IT nation of the world and we are IT giants. We do that. This, even to survive your IT, you need water. without water technologies, whatever you do is useless, according to me. Okay, we need to seriously think about water, and I'm very happy and congratulate Sahyadri to put this as a major theme in the day one of the conference itself. Water, calling even physicists and biologists and chemists with Nobel Laureates here, but putting water as a bright spot, you should congratulate them. Please give a big hand. A lot more need to be accomplished in securing earth storage. That means I keep telling you, repeating this. We are a storage star country, we need to do more storage. So you might ask the question, have you not done enough, sir, in India? Because we have got independence almost 70 years now. So when 1947, we had 300 dams, large dams, not in Kerala, ಅದನ್ನು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಮತ್ತು ತಮಿಳುನಾಡು ಆಂಧ್ರಪ್ರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ 300,000 ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೆರೆಗಳಿದ್ದಾವೆ. ಒಂದೊಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಹಳ್ಳಿಗೂ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಕೆರೆ. ಆ ಕೆರೆ ಗುಂಟೆಗಳು ಮಾಯ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಅದನ್ನ ತಡೀರಿ. ಕೆರೆ ಗುಂಟೆಗಳು ಮಾಯ ಆಗುವುದನ್ನು ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಬೇಕು ನಾವು. ಆ ಇದ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಂತೂ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಕೆರೆಗಳು ಮಾಯ ಆಗುವುದು. ಕೆಂಪೇಗೌಡರು ಕಟ್ಟಿದ್ದ ಕೆರೆಗಳು ಅದರ ಲಿಂಕೇಜಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಯ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇವತ್ತು ನೀರಿಲ್ಲ ಹೊರಕಂಡ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ? ಆ ಕೆರೆಗಳಿಂದ ನೀವು ಕುಡಿದೇ ಇರುವ ನೀವು. ಬಟ್ ಆ ಕೆರೆಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ನ ರೀಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು, ರೀಪ್ಲೆನಿಷ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಆವಾಗ ನೀರು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇರ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಇವಾಗ ಕೆರೆಗಳೇ ಮಾಯ ಆಗೋದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತಂದುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಕಟ್ಟದೆ, ಏರ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್ಟದೆ, ಮೆಟ್ರೋ ಕಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇದ್ರೆ ಆ ನಾಟ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕ್ರೈ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಎಷ್ಟು ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಕಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಜವಾಹರಲಾಲ್ ನೆಹರು 1960s '61 ಬಕ್ರಾಮಂಡಲ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಫೌಂಡೇಶನ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಒಂದು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ದಿ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಬಟ್ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಎನಿ ಮೋರ್. ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಮೋರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ನೌ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 225 ಮಿಲಿಯನ್ ಲೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಾ. ಅಮೆರಿಕಾದಲ್ಲಿ 12 ವರ್ಷ ಮಳೆ ಬರದೇ ಇದ್ರು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಲೇಕ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಾರ್ಡರ್ ಕೆನಡಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಮೆರಿಕಾ, ದೇ ಸರ್ವೈವ್. ಸಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವಾರ್ ಟೂ, ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ವಾಟರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗಿವ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಟು ಸೌದಿ ಅರೇಬಿಯಾ ಅಂಡ್ UAE ಬೈ ಪೈಪ್ ಲೈನ್. ಸಚ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ವಾಟರ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಸರ್, ಬಟ್ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟರ್. And don't be worried about environmental damage by storing this water, because we can't store all the water. There is no technology around you. You can only store, I told you, 5-7% ee varshadalli na madirodu 6000 dam kattidida alla halado 6000 dam 6000 last dam ond large dam andre inda sari helbuttini 15 meter kinta etra irodu 1 million meter cube water storage idre 12 meter idrunu appa large dam anta kattivi. ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ 0.75 million ಮೀಟರ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರ್ಥ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್. ಎನಿ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಇದು ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್. ಆ ಥರದ್ದು ನಾವು 6000 ಕಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ ಸಾರಿ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್. 6000 ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಕಟ್ಟೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ನದಿಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ನಿಂತೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಮನೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಡ್ಯಾಮನ್ನ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಟೌನ್ಶಿಪ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರೇ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಇದನ್ನೇ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಒದ್ದಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಯತ್ತಿನೊಳಗೆ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ? ನಮಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಅದು ಮಾತಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಉಪಯೋಗ ಇಲ್ಲ ಈಗ. ಬಟ್ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಟು ಸೇ ದೀಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜಿಂಗ್. ಬಟ್ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ದೆಮ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ದೆಮ್. ಈಗ ನಾವು ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್. ಅನ್ಚೆಕ್ಡ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ has inflicted similar damage on the river ecosystems. That is why our rivers are dry. Not just rains. Rains are happening randomly, episodically. Chirapunji is to receive 4,000 millimeters. Today Chirapunji may not receive, but somewhere else will receive. So average rainfall has not changed, but the change in the intensity of rainfall. You are not there. When you are not there, when the winter only 30 mm, 25 mm. Okay, when the winter only, after the rainfall is so intense and erratic, is happening. ಈಗ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಕಟ್ಟಿರೋ ಕೇರಳ ಸಂಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಚ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಬರ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರೇ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಚ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಇನ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸಾಧ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಲೆಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಟು ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್. ಮುಂಚೆಲ್ಲ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಟ್ರೀಸು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಇರೋದು. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ರಿಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಟುಡೇ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಬಿಲೋ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಹಾರಿಸೋಟಿಕ್ ಪರ್ಮಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಗಂಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಳ ಹೊಡೆದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಗಂಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಡ್ರೈ ಎಂದು ಯು ಹ್ ಸೀನ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆನಿ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಎರೋಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲೇಷನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಲೂಸ್ ದರ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಡ್ರೈ. ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಅನದರ್ ಕಾಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್. ಸೊ ಡಿಗ್ರಿಡೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಎರೋಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಲೇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅರ್ತ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜೀಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ರಿಯಲಿ ಸಸ್ಟೈನ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಸಸ್ಟೈನಬಲ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜೀಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀ ಒನ್ ಡೇಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಗಿವ್ 2 ಅವರ್ಸ್ 1 ಅವರ್ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ಹರ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ ಆಫ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ this is a wrong notion that if we give 2 hours water we can save water. But you see why did we do that? Because I have plotted y axis investment and operational cost. This one, the operational cost is power. So people would like to go for this, but this is not the really solution. Actually people have shown that by restricting water you are not really encouraging sustainability. Your people start storing water more. They will really want to store water for when that is not available. They will start creating tanks below their house, below their car garage, below their kitchen or whatever it is, you know, and start storing water. So the other technologies are wastewater recycling, desalination plants, irrigation transfers, inland dams. Look at the cost, operational, and all of these are really high, sir. I don't know, we have chosen wrongly some of the technologies for storing water. So, rainwater harvesting is very reasonably cheaper, but the problem is, it's much cheaper actually, but adequacy, sustainability may not be possible because you can only store some X amount of water and in that X is 0.35 only is the porosity of any approximately 0.3%. 30% only you can store in the ground. In that 30% some water you cannot retrieve because it is a water which will be there in the soil, some rock particles surrounding that. So we can only take out about 20-25% water can be taken out. So the quantity of water available underground may be enough for all domestic purposes. And today what we are doing, why the groundwater is going down? Because we are heavily using it for agriculture. You don't know, governments have given free water to every Sunday for farmers. So there is simply pumping. They will not even go to the farmland now. They will simply put the pump on and come down and sleep. And what is going? Simply coming. Then why groundwater will not go down? We are actually trying to control something in urbanization area. But let me tell you, shortage and usage is maximum in rural area in water. No planning of the government has done for that. Show me one area they have done worked on water conservation in villages than in urban areas. Urban areas they are making very mandatory for rainwater harvesting. But urban areas are not the problem here. Problem is 92% of water is used by farmers and their demand is also there so. So we need to do something very, very critically in technologies and awareness for the farmers. So that has to be taken up according to me and seriously. So let us look at the rivers. See, I come to the second part of my talk, river rejuvenation. Okay? So rivers, there are three parts you can divide the river. Particularly when you are sitting in Bangalore, it is very easy to show this picture. Everybody will understand because right here, the Dravati is there. Right here, the Dravati is going. What is happening? It bounds in the western parts and carries with all the small streams. So what happens in there, flow is very high velocity in some small gorges. The cross section will be very small, like this. It is not like this. Okay? And in the middle course, the water flows in a moderate velocity. and vertical, and there will be meanders, and dams are also constructed here only. Please note that. Very few dams are there in the hills. Okay, only Chakra is there in Karnataka, and then Savayakudu, and there are 2-3 dams in Karnataka, and Koyna dam is in also Western Ghats. But less than them are in this, particularly the East flowing rivers, which are Kaveri and Tungabhadra, Krishna, Udari. Large dams are there actually in the middle course of the river. And the last lower course is the ocean, where it joins the ocean. Okay. Some of the rivers, you might say, no sir, if you don't leave any water, how the fishes will survive? Definitely, those are all the issues we have not forgotten. Please understand, all of that is being taken into consideration, and the world over, large amount of work has been happening on the coastal reservoirs. Scope of rejuvenation of this river is there are 3-4 points. Innovative and integrated method to harvest rainwater and recharge groundwater is very key, and there is no second word about this. Everybody has to follow. If you want to really conserve our water, best is the groundwater. It is available in non-monsoon seasons for you as a safety for you. It is like works like a storage tank for you, which is buried in the ground. Water is available to you. Reduce the rate of runoff. This is what we have to do in the rivers. Reduce the lateral flow and subsurface flow. We need to cut down the flow of water. See, you want to make the Malayadi to a very poor idea. அது அந்த கட்டில் காலியாக போட்டேன் எழுதுகிற அடையும் நல்ல சந்தோஷத்தை அந்த ஃபுல்லோ அந்த கட்டு பண்ணவே நாம் அள்ளி 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 பராஜஸ் ஆகும் முச்சிந்த நம்ம டெக்னாலஜிஸ் எல்லாம் அதை ஸ்டாப் பண்ணுறதுக்கு பெஸ்ட் அந்த ஆஸ் அ எவ்ரிபடி சைட் அண்ட் ஐ ஒன் ஸ்ரீ ஜெனி வாசுதேவ சைட் பிளான் ட்ரீஸ் லார்ஜ் ட்ரீஸ் விச் ஆர் நாட் லைக் ஒன் விச் டேக்ஸ் வாட்டர் அவே ஃப்ரம் யூ ஓகே விச் கன்சர்வ்ஸ் வாட்டர் சச் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ட்ரீஸ் ஹவ் டு பீ ஐடென்டிஃபைட் and plant it there. That is one good thing, but that is not the only one will help because we require large amount of water. So raise the water levels in the upstream watershed, sustain the waste flow and the runoff in the downstream basin till the next rainy season. Relevant structures have to be designed based on geomorphology, lithology, geological structure. See, time immemorial, please understand, all the structures which I am going to show you in a couple of minutes. Are actually done by local people with a local technology. There is a local world for downstreams. And they are the best, even today, one of the best rainwater harvesting techniques, whether it is irrigation or it is drinking water or domestic water. Groundwater rejuvenation using combination of various water recharging techniques and appropriate locations is very essential. So, what are the possible rainwater techniques? Check dams. Everybody knows nalla banks, contour trenches, percolation tanks, soap pits, surangas. Remember like a suranga hole. The lateral level water is horizontal like a suranga hole. Particularly, our water is very thin. Our water is collect money, irrigation. Get to the use of that water. That is all Maya. Because our suranga hole is not there. Technology was not there. They have to go physically excavate. So height of dam should be the height of the surangas. Okay, otherwise he has to crawl on the cut out the mouth. Today there are not technologies you can even drill horizontal well of 100 to 150 mm with beautiful geotechnology, geomembrane, geofabrics, use what you can fantastically get that water which is underground. Then subsurface dikes, I'll show you. Entire Japan survives on subsurface dikes. Sand dams. All the South American, South African countries, lot of sand dams. That means the new storing in water in sand does two purposes. One, it doesn't allow people to take away the sand. Second, if you store water, evaporation losses will be less. I'll show you the data in a little while. Evaporation losses below the sand layer is very less when compared to the open pond. Open pond evaporates completely, very quickly, if the temperature goes up. Infiltration wells, injection wells, water pools, subsurface dams or underground dams, it's also called as. Our last resort is a coastal reservoir that will require a large amount of water because all that water will be at the end of the river. See, this is nobody's water because it's joining the ocean. So today, interbasin transfers require all the state to accept, whether they like it or not, upper Iberian, lower Iberian, we have 17 water capitals fighting forever. I don't think the any minister or any prime minister can solve fight between Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. They have their own arguments, both of them are correct. I will tell you, both of them are correct statistically. Tamil Nadu, you cannot deny the water for a lower riparian state just because they are higher. Okay? Upper, you cannot put all the dams in. Oh, it is my water. No, it is not correct. If rivers have to survive, rivers have to flow throughout, that means you cannot allow large dams to come in the upper riparian states. Similarly, lower riparian cannot take away all the water, not coming in the back of water, just because they were agreement. Done in 1900s or under the British government. Okay? There are some agreements done. When the British government, when the head of the boss was sitting in Chennai, he got influenced by some people locally there and written down something. That cannot be the rule of the law. So,